I do a lot of assignments in classes, and me and Casey usually collaborate.
I can collaborate with others so we can get a finalised piece to everybody's expectations.
I enjoy working with other people because you get other people's insight on how to do the work.
My name is Peter Marshall. I'm principal here at the Ormiston Denes Academy in Lowestoft. Lowestoft is a coastal town nestled between Suffolk and Norfolk. Our catchment is very broad in its intake, and we serve those who are both very economically challenged as a result of a declining industry base here in the town over many years, and those that are of a more normal distributive background.
So we had a very sort of traditional Windows network with an Exchange server. And this Exchange server was becoming quite antiquated and out of date. We looked at the Google Apps for Education piece to move beyond having an on-site server, something that we didn't have to look after, didn't have to back up anymore.
What we've embraced is a blended approach that puts Chromebooks into some areas of the school curriculum, and we purchased 180 as our first order of those. We kept and maintained our desktop infrastructure, and what we're looking to sustain is a mixed base. What we want to see our students using is a combination of desktop, mobile, tablet and smartphone technologies as and when the purpose of their activity, the intended learning, lend itself to one or other of those applications.
When I first was actually asked by Peter to look at the Google Apps piece, I was actually quite nervous. It was something new, it was something that I didn't understand, it's something that I'd not considered or seen before. And as soon as I turned on Google and I looked at the documentation that they presented, the guides that they just started to write at that time, I was like, actually, this is quite interesting.
I had not used Google previously, apart from very basic things. New initiatives and new things that come in teaching, it really is survival of the fittest. If it's not going to save you energy and time, but still have as good or better impacts on teaching and learning, and then you're not going to use it. Straight away, I realised actually it was quite impressive. It wasn't until we got the Chromebooks that I realised actually just how much it can break down the barriers in the classroom.
For our students, the key benefits are really the iterative marking process that our staff can engage in alongside their work.
It's much easier for teachers to mark it. We can actually mark it live, so we can have a finalised piece to the teacher's standard straight away.
If something isn't quite right and they need to go back and they need to change it and they need to work on it, there's not a big red line. There's nothing there that is going to stay there forever. Whereas in a book, and we still use books, but sometimes if they made a mistake, the actual act of putting something red through it, or for them striking it out themselves, is it's a failure for some of them.
What is clear is where use of IT is extensive, where they've used it appropriately and engaged in that iterative marking cycle, that those students and those subjects are seeing greater gains than anybody else.
The Google Docs, Google Sheets, all those apps allows them to actually communicate, talk to, reply to comments staff are making, and of course through the drive they've got access wherever they want.
I use my desktop to edit work from school at home. There was a history assessment about 4 weeks ago maybe, and I hadn't quite finished it, and I think I did it on my phone.
Well, you can easily just at home just log into your Google account and then just go onto your drive, and then you can access all the files you made at school, which you have uploaded to your Google Drive on your account.
Sometimes I log in on my iPad at home onto Google, and I just sometimes text Casey on my phone and I put, we need to finish this, and I invite him in to finishing this assignment, and I just find it easier that way.
It's just opened up my classroom. I don't have to be in the same school to actually help them learn. I don't even have to be in the same country anymore. If I'm away on a conference, they're sharing with me their work, and I'm just keeping an eye out, I'm just checking, I'll get the odd question and I can fire it back. So it's really opened up learning in a way that I didn't think was really possible.
My teaching was isolated before we went to Google Apps. Now, students are commenting back to me, replying back to me all times of the day. They are ready to study, they know what they're studying. They've already, some of them, done research and looking at the work they're going to be covering and coming in with ideas.
Over the next 18 months, we're interested in growing our use of IT even further. We currently have a ratio of about one device to every two pupils, but we don't necessarily think we've found the optimum level yet.
In the future, I expect that around the academy it'll be a multi-platform environment. I'd like to see a Mac suite in. I'd like to see some more Windows devices. I do know that we are going to be deploying more Chromebooks. Whatever devices that we use in the future, we do know that on the backbone, what's going to be supporting them will be Google Apps for Education.
I think it gives you more of a target range, like as in higher levels and things you can improve on.
It makes it easier to do work because most people type faster, and then you've got the access to the internet so you can work independently as well.
It's much better because it's much more portable, so you can just quickly take it at lunch or something and just quickly start working on little pieces while you're with your friends.